Hello and welcome back to Quote Friday. My name is Sriyamtas Sekaran and I'm doing any Friday some quotes when I and I also talk about these quotes and what they mean to me. First, let me start. The first one is one that Einstein alleged once have said is the only people who have never made a mistake are people who have never tried something new. Anybody make mistakes, specifically when they're starting out in a new area they want to become an expert in. Some make less mistakes than others. The mistakes of some will not be a peril by some. Some mistakes are not considered mistakes by our current system. But anybody makes mistakes, even I sometimes. But I don't make a lot of mistakes, and I correct them often before somebody put them out. When other of Einstein is the definition of insanity is doing something over and over again and expecting a different result. Some people question if Einstein have ever said it. I know by some people it is a controversial topic if he ever said it, but if we are starting to think about this actually a little bit, you can see that it is true. If you are actually doing the same thing, for example constant fighting against justice, you see that anything always comes to the same spiral of involve. Then first you have the insane people who are the oppressors, they are fighting for their rights to be the holders of their privileged statics, when they are claiming that the abolitionists are the self-righteous one, when they are themselves self-righteous. By the way, self-righteous means that it's not that only or mainly benefit you. Fighting for the rights of other living beings is not self-righteous. That is righteous. If you are living in a world where it is not societally acceptable to fight for the rights of children, and you still do that, it's not self-righteous, that is courage. Because you have the courage to actually stand up against the status quo and say the status quo is wrong as hell. The status quo is not right just because it is the status quo. That's in around 100 countries around the world. That's actually slightly the majority of the countries accepted by as official countries by the UN. Then that does also not make it right. Remember, you should always assume the position of the victims. You have to place yourself in the victim's position, not the of the oppressor. Because if you are the oppressor, it becomes pretty easy to mock, ridicule, and make easily more than 30 excuses why you should exploit them. This is easy. There's always what I say in any situations. You replace animal with woman, with child, with mental retard. You replaced it with homosexuals. They always say, prove to me why I should be kind to you. Prove to me why I am should not treat you like you are lesser than me. You are stupid. You are don't act like me. You don't speak the way I do. You don't walk the way I do. You are don't have the same skin color as I. You don't have the same ancestral patterns as me. You don't come out of the same clan as me. You don't, again, over and over. But the plain fact is all not important when it comes to morality. It all have nothing to do with being right. This nothing to do with being compassionate. It have nothing to do with pure justice. Justice is not a system of political rhetoric. It is not a law, or must I better refer to it as a law. Because the majority of the laws that we have made up are actually lore. There are stories, rules that we have made up. Some are pretty logical, some are pretty illogical. For example, that animals have no personal rights according to the law, but a business has actually a thing, have personal rights. Holy shit, what the freaking weird world we live in. Do you agree? Slaves were considered two-fifths of a person. Women were considered often the half of a man, of her man. And when she was married, according to the German social code, she was property of the of her husband. So that was still in the 19th century German code to 1900s, year 1900, where most European systems of law are built on. Basically, this quote of Einstein, when he said the definition of insanity is doing something over and over and expecting different results, can be implied when it comes to law. Slave masters say it is law. The appeal to law fallacy. The appeal to social contract fallacy. All those arguments are used by slave masters. Check out Hammond's letters on slavery. He said that the white man have the right to enslave the black man because Adam was given a dominion over his fellow man. Like Carnists like to point out that we have dominion over animals because God give dominion over animals to man. He also used parts of the Bible to justify it. So if you are curious, check out his essays, his letters on slavery, in defense of it. I know there are a lot of very crunchy stuff in it, but most of that, if you replace the naga with the animal, or negro with the animal, or African savages, never forget that slaves were considered property. They were transported on the same ships that transported livestock. They were considered livestock. They were property, livestock, living property, and living tools. Let that sink in. Further, this world is a dangerous place, not because of the people who are evil, but because of the people who don't stand up against the evil. Another one of Einstein after World War II. Elie Wiesel also said something similar. He said that the opposite of love is not hatred. It is apathy. Because apathy is the one thing that lets evil succeed. It lets themselves be used for the greater torture by the ones who practice the intention of malice. Another way to explain this, that hatred, just as love, is a strong, passionate emotion. The one cares, the other cares to hate. When the one who's consumed by hatred have nothing to fight against anymore, they will miss the one to fight. Are missing out their opposite. In contrary with apathy, egocentrism, because they don't care. They are, I don't care if it benefits me. I'm for it. I'm an optimist, an optimist. I am taking any opportunity. I'm taking my part of the cake. And I don't blame myself. That's what Hitler was doing. Hitler was profiting of the apathy of the Dutch people, who wants to blame somebody for their own economical crisis after World War I. So Hitler created one scapegoat, one mocking point, one sacrificing creature or group. He blamed for all the problems. And that were the Jews, the Gypsies, and some other groups. He called this a Holocaust. The Greeks worked for a sacrifice, same ritual of destroying, murdering one male calf, baby cow, maybe herd animal, you also can say, on the altar of God. Check it out. Holocaust is a sacrificing ritual of life sacrifice of a herd animal on the altar of some god. Or must I say devil? Because no god will be a killer of his animals, his babies. No, my friends. I suggest we should call it a devil, because that sounds more like something a devil will do. When darkness and light become one, the reality is split away and the truth become visible.